Public Works, please stand by. We have a couple of unidentified barrels.
This is an annual exercise that we do with the tactical first aid teams, and those are multidiscipline teams comprised of fire, law enforcement, Public Works, Florida Power and Light, Verizon. We put these teams together prior to hurricane season, and they assemble in a safe location, usually one of our school facilities or another safe building, during the storm. And as soon as the storm winds die down, they deploy on their own and they begin clearing emergency routes from the interstate to hospitals, critical facilities, and then they're on call for additional missions.
Hey, can you go over?
On our standpoint from the SO, basically we're here for law enforcement support. We're basically the first in to make sure the scene's safe.
Hey, Fox! Fox, clear out!
We secure the scene, make sure there's no people that are a danger to anybody out here, and then of course we assess the area first and then radio back to those entities on what we need and forward.
The tactical first aid teams, they're comprised of cross-agency personnel. So we have Florida Power and Light, Public Works, Transit Bus, and these teams go out as a defined unit. They're equipped to be self-sufficient for 72 hours, and this mission is to, again, clear those roadways from the critical facilities to these major roadways.
Phil, it takes a lot of partnerships and cooperation to get it done, but then it all culminates here in the exercise, and it gives them hands-on experience on what they can see when they're out there after a real disaster. I would tell the public that we need them to stay home after a storm and stay off the streets until these guys get their work done. There's a lot of debris, there's roofing nails, there's a lot of hazards out there that have to be cleared, and we don't want anybody getting hurt. So we ask the public to cooperate with us, stay off the streets until this work is done.